shocking announcement from the SEC shows just how far crypto has come. JP Morgan says that the dollar is doomed in the Trans-Siberian crypto smuggling game. Now, before we get into those stories, if you are looking for a way to get the edge on your altcoin investing, then you need to go and check out Symmetry. This is put on by the guys from Crypto Briefing, and they are creating the exact same kinds of high-level, in-depth reports that the big venture capital firms get for their investments, as well as coin ratings, picks of the month, and market updates. Remember, knowledge is power, and knowledge gives you the edge in your investing. There is a referral link down below where you can get signed up. If you do sign up using this link, I will receive a small commission at no additional cost to you. So, let's start off with a nice little feel-good story. In Brazil, we have another big win for crypto adoption. Citizens of the Brazilian city of Fortaleza, with a population of 2.6 million, will soon be able to pay crypto for public transport within the city. Now, for now, there are only plans to accept Bitcoin, but more cryptos might be added in the future. People in general, though, are a bit hesitant to spend their crypto, especially on mundane things like paying for a monthly bus pass, but this is nevertheless a big bit of adoption to see another major city accepting cryptocurrencies for public transport. Today, a Bitcoin whale has moved $468 million worth of Bitcoin for less than $400. That's a lot of Bitcoin, guys. Now look, it is not like these kinds of massive transactions have not taken place before, but wow, every time it happens, it just really underlines how awesome Bitcoin is. I mean, sure, the guy paid $375 in fees, but look how powerful that is. No ID check, no one to ask permission to, no third party to trust, completed in less than an hour at any time of day that he wanted. Just massive wealth moved from point A to point B. Now, $375 may seem like a lot for a transfer, but in reality, it is not that much money. Compare it to a bank or a remittance provider, and the fees would have likely been in the tens of thousands, if not much more, not to mention all the complications around regulations and all that stuff. And of course, there'd be no privacy in that transaction, and you could only move your money during business hours. The banks are in big trouble, guys. This is changing the entire game. And here is another story that proves it. Millions of dollars a day in crypto is crossing the Russia-China border every single day. So funny that China thought that they could stop crypto inside of China. Trying to stop crypto is like trying to stop a train with a blade of grass. It just doesn't work. So apparently Chinese importers in Russia are buying up to $30 million a day of Tether from Moscow's over-the-counter trading desks. The Chinese merchants are then using USDT to send money back into China, which of course has very strict capital controls, with the government limiting the amount of foreign currency that anyone can buy or sell to $50,000 a year. They're also, of course, bypassing the Russian banks in the process and most likely bypassing paying any taxes in Russia. Previously, the merchants used Bitcoin for these transactions, but according to an owner of one of the OTC desks over there in Moscow, when the market crashed back in 2018, the Chinese merchants switched over to Tether. When the OTC desk representative was asked about Tether and whether he thinks it is backed, his answer was, "No one really cares about that here." Interesting. Reportedly, though, about 20% of the daily purchases are still in Bitcoin at these Moscow OTC desks. But the volatility does make it, of course, much less attractive for these merchants, so I kind of understand why they're using a stablecoin. So let's move on to everyone's favorite bank, JP Morgan. A strategist at the bank has said that changing habits among non-US central banks are creating a real sense of unease about the dollar's long-term status, which is of course no surprise considering that US policy is increasingly pushing countries like China and Russia away from the dollar. While the U.S. dollar has long served as the global reserve currency, many are calling for an end to the dollar's monopoly on global finance, especially as the dollar is becoming increasingly weaponized against the U.S. geopolitical competitors. The dollar is seeing increasing competition as well from foreign powers, as we can see the launch of new SWIFT alternatives in Europe and Russia and China, increasing acceptance internationally of the Chinese yuan, and of course things like Iran switching over to euros for international settlements. And of course, gold. Central banks across the globe are gobbling up gold like it is going out of style, with countries like Russia adding to their gold reserves at their strongest pace on record. 2018 saw the strongest demand for gold from central banks since 1971. JP Morgan also noted that the dollar's declining overall share of central bank reserves has dipped from 64% back in 2008 to 55% today. The power poles are shifting, guys. U.S. global economic dominion is waning, which means that the U.S. dollar will struggle to remain the top international currency in the coming decades. The USD status as the globally dominant currency simply cannot continue forever, especially as we see the rise of powerful economic players in Asia really starting to put themselves out there. Trade wars, of course, just putting additional pressure on an already shaken dollar, and the insurmountable debt mountain domestically in the United States just keeps getting bigger, all spelling big trouble for the dollar in the long run. The only advice, according to the bank, is to get rid of U.S. dollar overweights in investment portfolios and to diversify. For some, that will be gold or euros or yuan. But all of this just paints a perfect scenario for Bitcoin and cryptocurrencies to step in. Obviously, JP Morgan said nothing about crypto, even though they do have their own crypto they're launching, but they didn't say anything about Bitcoin. But it would be crazy to think that some of these central banks are not getting even just a little bit of crypto. Just a little bit. I see it as an absolute inevitability that a country will come out one of these days and announce, hey, we bought 50,000 Bitcoin last year. And then comes country-level FOMO, guys, as others scramble to get a big old stack of Bitcoin. In other corporate bank news, a massive hack has compromised the personal information, including names, incomes, dates of birth, addresses, phone numbers, email addresses, social security numbers for up to 140,000 people apparently were also maintained, and yes, 80,000 bank account numbers were also accessed. In total, 106 million people at Capital One in North America were affected in one way or another by this hack. Now, apparently, this massive data hack happened back in March, but the company only disclosed the information now after the hacker, who apparently wanted to actually get caught, started dumping the information publicly on GitHub. But the company knew. The company knew for 4 months, and they only admitted to the hack because the hacker publicly started dumping everything online. Yeah, kind of sounds like something a bank would do, isn't it? Guess they were all too busy just, I don't know, getting lit on coke or something like that. Too busy to care about the privacy of their 100 plus million customers. It's crazy. And it just really underlines the need for decentralized identity services. How many times has Bitcoin been hacked? Zero. That's how many times. Privacy concerns in the modern era are absolutely reaching a tipping point, and data centralization has become completely out of control and unsustainable. All of which, of course, is pushing companies like Microsoft to develop decentralized blockchain-based alternatives for identity management. And in the case of Microsoft specifically, they're building that on top of Bitcoin. And finally, the SEC. They have made a very, very surprising announcement. The SEC is planning to run nodes for Bitcoin, Ethereum, Bitcoin Cash, Stellar, Zcash, EOS, NEO, and XRP. No Dogecoin, surprisingly. But wow, guys, just wow. Look at how far we have come. This is crazy. Now, the stated reasons are, of course, to monitor risk and improve compliance and inform commission policy with respect to digital assets and all that fun stuff. And, of course, to source all the blockchain data themselves from hosted nodes rather than being provided this data from a secondary source. Now, they are planning to contract out to a third party all the nitty-gritty bits of actually running the nodes and then getting the data and having the basically a third-party contractor report everything back to them. But wow, this is still big. I feel like, you know, for as long as the SEC has been demanding to have their interference in the crypto industry respected, respect my authority, they're kind of getting in this a bit late, running the nodes, right? Should have done this a couple years ago, but anyway. Better late to the party than never, I guess, but now outside of gobbling up all this data and all these different things, I hope that it deepens their understanding of crypto and the ecosystem, actually allows them to offer better rules for crypto companies moving forward, not to increase pain for these companies. But look, you're not going to find me rolling out a red carpet for the SEC, but you do have to, I think, appreciate the gravity of this situation. What a crazy month it has been. The U.S. president has tweeted about Bitcoin. The Treasury Secretary has been talking about Bitcoin. Congress has been holding hearings talking about Bitcoin. And now the SEC is going to be running nodes for multiple blockchains. Wild times, guys. Anyway, just my two stoves. You guys let me know what you think about these or any other stories down below in the comment section. Thank you guys so much, as always, for watching today's video. You guys are totally freaking awesome, and I really, really appreciate your time. And of course, if you did enjoy this video, hit that thumbs up button, guys. It'd be super awesome. Make sure to subscribe to the channel if you're new around here, and click on that notification bell to know when I put out a new video. Long live the blockchain, and peace out till next time.